Right now, the big story, of course, is going to be what is happening on the line of control. The Army Chief General Bikram Singh is speaking right now. Let's listen in.
I know the kind of vagaries you face of the environment while putting your mind together in various reports. It's not an easy thing. And my, on behalf of all ranks of the Indian Army, let me compliment you all and convey my greetings to you in this regard. And I think you're doing a great job in this regard. Ladies and gentlemen, I take this opportunity to convey my condolences at the outset to the bereaved families of our soldiers who have made the ultimate sacrifice since the last Army Day in 2012. And the total figures are 91 all ranks, which includes 6 officers, 8 JCOs and 77 other ranks. These officers, JCOs and men have made the ultimate, the supreme sacrifice in the line of duty and in the best traditions of the Indian Army. And I feel that we need to salute these. I, on behalf of all ranks of the Indian Army, I salute these gentlemen who in the very noble cause have laid down their lives. My heart especially goes out today to the families of 2 soldiers who were killed on the 8th, who were mutilated, their bodies were mutilated after that operation on the 8th by the Pakistani regulars. It was a gruesome act, most unpardonable act. We have lodged a very strong protest in this regard to the government, to the DGMO, and this is being taken up today. Alongside this act, it defies all logic. It's against the very principles and rules of engagement. It's against the very ethics of soldiering and professionalism. And therefore, in very strong terms, we have taken up this case with the government of Pakistan, through our government. You would have heard the statements of the Raksha Mantri, you would have heard the statement of the Minister of External Affairs. The DGMOs have conveyed this on the, during the DGMO talk. And this morning, this afternoon, in fact, at 1 o'clock, when we have this flag meeting today at the brigade commander's level, this again is being put across, being lodged, this protest being lodged in a very strong manner today. I wish to clarify a few aspects, ladies and gentlemen, with regard to this incident, because we've had varying descriptions coming about on this incident. The first thing I wish to highlight is that there was no operation undertaken by the Indian Army on the 6th, as alleged by the Pakistan Army. And this has been covered widely, they've been talking about it, but having ascertained from ground, it's with conviction that I'm telling you that no operation was carried out by the Indian Army on the 6th. The other thing about blaming one of the commanders, that there was a commander who was very aggressive and as a result of this, this has started. Well, I expect all my commanders on the line of control to be aggressive and offensive in the face of provocation and firing. I don't expect my commanders to be timid. And from that point of view, I think the commanders on the LC are doing a great job and their morale has to be kept high. They're doing a wonderful job. They are operating, they are conducting themselves in a professional manner. Their response is always in retaliation to being provoked and not being fired at. And their response is always measured and for effect. The other aspect I wish to highlight in this regard is a word about Charunda village. You know, media has been covering, and a certain amount of impression has been given that the entire thing has started from there. I wish to clarify, and we have a picture of village Charunda, which will be shown to you during the break after this. It's been carried by DDGPI. He will show it to you. From the picture, you will see that Charunda village is dominated by the Pakistani posts. And therefore, when it is dominated, it has also been subjected to large number of times to small arms and mortar fire. The month of October. The other aspect I wish to highlight in this regard is a word about Charunda village. You know, media has been covering, and a certain amount of impression has been given that the entire thing has started from there. I wish to clarify, and we have a picture of village Charunda, which will be shown to you during the break after this. It's being carried by DDGPI. He will show it to you. From the picture, you will see that Chirunda village is dominated by the Pakistani posts. And therefore, when it is dominated, it has also been subjected to large number of times to small arms firing and mortar firing. You may recall that in the month of October, there were 3 civilians who had been killed in the village Chirunda, which included one lady, a pregnant lady of 23 years old. Now, in that area, when you are being fired upon, you don't expect the soldiers to walk in the open. And therefore, the soldiers have prepared a communication trench, a crawl trench, and an observation post. There is no concrete defense works in this area. I wish to assure you this. And therefore, this information which came up, that it was on account of this, it's all false. And let me also tell you, this kind of activity goes on both sides. Repression of defenses, modification of defenses, upkeep of defenses is the ongoing activity along the line of control. And I must share this with you, right from my company days to the core day, I have commanded on the line of control. And I have enough experience with regard to this. And I've also thought that some of you, in fact most of you who are old timers have been to the LC, but those who wish to go there again, I've already thought of it, I've told the DGMO, will be too glad to take you to the LC to make you understand the dynamics of line of control. What exactly goes on over there? Because once you perceive, once you see that for yourself, you'll find your reporting will fall in the correct perspective. And you'll be able to appreciate this incident, how it occurred and why it occurred, and what needs to be done. Therefore, we will try and take you there at the earliest, the moment things stabilize, we'll take you to that area. The other thing I wish to highlight is that this response, they launched this operation. Now, ladies and gentlemen, such operations require time for planning and execution. The execution, very fact, has taken place, but this kind of operation requires detailed reconnaissance. And where they are blaming us for this in Uri area, the operation has been launched south of Pir Panjal in Mandar area. In other words, their troops were poised for this operation. Pakistan was only looking at, the Pakistan army was essentially looking at justifying, legitimizing this action. So therefore, this entire information campaign which was launched by them, which is based on lies, has got to be understood in the correct perspective.
India's number one news app just got even better. Download NDTV's new app, fully optimized for retina display, full screen view, faster response time, and Sudoku. NDTV's new iPad app. Download now.